Hey people, this is Arad. My pronouns are he, him, and welcome to Rise of the Demigods.
Hi, my name is Mackenzie Wilkes. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I play Astrid Elvea, the demigoddess of constellations and wild elf ranger rogue.
Hi, my name is Arvi. My pronouns are he, him, and I play Janice de Cassiel, the demigod of secrets and Asimar bard.
Hey, Yakety Pack. It's me, Nikki C, coming at you with my intro. I played Barb, the human monk, demigod of bones, the only human monk in the world. Said that before and I'm saying it again. Their pronouns are they and them, and so are mine. What up?
Hey, my name is Joey, and I play Teodor Zeldaya, the demigod of diamonds, and mine and his pronouns are he and him. Welcome to Rise of the Demigods.
Last time on Rise of the Demigods, you all had broken away from the school, stolen an airship.
Stop saying stolen.
Taken an airship.
Borrowed.
We didn't ask permission.
Absconded with an airship.
You need to ask for forgiveness.
Ask for forgiveness.
Along with 14 of the other students.
Yes.
Right?
One of them might
12.
Be Ronald McDonald.
Right? Tula wasn't in there and Demron isn't there.
Right.
But
right.
It was 16 with all of us. So Zenda's there. So 11 other students.
11 other students.
Yeah.
Because it was 16 total, right? We're four.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yes, correct. Correct. All right. 11 other students.
No, it'd be 10 then. Because it's
10 other students.
Yeah. It's we're...
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Gotcha.
No Demron, no Zendar. No
bunch
Tula.
Of students.
Nine? How many?
A lot.
Anyway,
a lot.
We had fun on our magic school bus.
Right.
And we flew for a bit.
For an hour.
Uh-huh.
And then you immediately descended.
Tired.
Right.
We got sleepy.
He said, fuck this, actually.
We got sleepy.
He said, I have an idea. Actually, fuck this.
Right. So you guys parked right by Wendell's home.
Uh-huh.
And Wendell was set.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, well, Wendell still had his parking permit for that neighborhood area, so we were able to use it.
We were immediately stopped by cops.
Yeah,
by
the
cops
came.
Exactly.
The cops came. We had to flush all of our drugs.
All of Kylie's vines.
Yep. The warden flew by and checked in with you all. You all fooled the warden.
Yeah.
Can we do a
Daddy Dima came out?
A role play recap.
Reaction.
Can I be the warden?
Yeah.
You're the warden.
Yeah.
Who are you casting? Who else is who?
Joey, you're Barb.
No!
Arvi, you're Astrid. And Mackenzie, you're Janice.
Okay.
All right, excellent.
Okay. Getting a character.
Can you roll it on the window?
Oh, God! The cops! Oh, God!
Guys, it's okay. It's okay. I have a fake ID. It's fine. Hi.
And scene.
Okay, I'd like to say
that was a good
points for both, dead on. But let's face it, the first thing Janice would have done is flirt with the cop.
Yeah, had the scene gone further, I would have. Do you have any pineapples?
Oh, are you going to put me in
handcuffs? I have three pairs in my coat.
What are you, some of mine?
What color do you like?
So the cops came, and then we tried calling Tree Lord, and a bird flew into the window and started scaring and shitting and yelling over all of our friends.
And what, do a reenactment of that?
Such an upsetting bird.
You used the word yells.
Yes, I did.
So
I
good.
Did.
It makes I me did. Laugh so hard.
Okay.
And that's where we join ourselves today. And Barb goes, what the fuck? And runs into the ramp.
Yeah, we're all gonna go in there.
Excellent. Then as you run in, you see the peregrine perched above
the parrot.
The parrot. just shouting you back at you. You see the peregrine perched over a bowl of water, and out of the lip
anus prolapsed.
Don't say that.
Why?
No, too much? No. Sorry.
Out of the lip of the bowl climbs this tiny little, you know, stuff here.
We can get this giggly after 5 hours of recording.
It's been like 2 minutes. Not
oh
even.
God.
Russ is going to be so disappointed in us.
Okay.
We're having a good time.
Yeah,
this is heaven. This is on brand.
Yeah. Let the poop seed speak.
So,
Barbie yells.
This little teeny trant that looks just like a steel beard, except for the fact that it doesn't have a beard, climbs up over the lip of the bowl, about 3 inches tall.
Has a lot of acne.
Dangling their feet. Yeah, there's like little gross.
Glasses,
yeah.
Braces.
Yeah. Yeah.
Little wooden bracelet made of vines.
And it goes, what?
Well, I didn't want to leave my room. I was watching YouTube Minecraft videos.
Because he desperately tries to connect with teens.
That's what my 12-year-old cousin does. I don't know. He does nothing but watch Minecraft videos.
Of other people playing Minecraft?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's like all he does.
A glare from Joey.
No, I know you have a server and it's like lots
Hi.
Of fun, but like.
My name's Joey and I'm 32 years old and I still play Minecraft. Want to join our server? Hit me up in Discord.
Go to twitch.tv/nomadic to watch Joey play The Sims and Minecraft.
And lots of other amazing games.
Yeah.
This isn't a promo for me. We're talking about Minecraft. Yeah.
What's Steeler doing other than being a Twitch ad?
Waiting for everyone, I guess. Just dangling with his little feet over the edge.
So tiny.
It's like.
Hello.
Hi, are you?
Hey, Astrid.
Oh, are you the same? Are you the same tree?
We are the same.
Is it like, but is it like a copy of the consciousness or is it the same one?
I am repeating all the actions you see here.
Where are you?
I'm on a boat.
You're a tree.
I am a tree.
That must suck.
Why?
You're not, never mind. I guess I assume too much.
You're like not in the ground.
Don't you need to be rooted in somewhere?
No, I am a tree. I mean, I can root and I will root, but I don't need to root all the time.
Whoa!
So are you repeating all these words on the boat as we speak?
Yes, he is. He's saying every single thing he's saying right now. Totally. Whoa.
Who's around you?
Yeah, about to say, are you around people right now? Before we ask you questions,
it's difficult. And then one moment, and then like the little teeny thing is like.
I'll grab it. I'll put it. I'll pick it up. We killed the little. Oh my god!
Just heads over, tongues low
okay,
out.
Okay, I'll pick
right?
it up and
Did
hold
you have
it.
Another leaf?
I do.
And then all of a sudden, it just pops what? Right up.
Okay. Boom. Hello.
A couple of the crewmen are around me. Yes.
And they can hear what you're saying.
Yes.
Hey.
They seem to find it quite amusing.
What do you do when you go to the bathroom?
I do not so much. Do you know what a tree is?
Yeah, but apparently they could be on boats, so...
Heard of it.
That's right. He would go into some detail about how treants excrete waste.
All right, I'm ready.
I don't know what he says. But
Ron, this is your world. You can paint the picture.
No, I got to call Darcy on this one. Darcy Ross, the only person I know who I could call, and she'd be like, this is exactly how it would work.
Let's tweet. See if we can get it by the end of the episode.
Tweet at us.
Tweet at us how you treat shit. Yeah. So can we ask you a few questions?
Sure.
Hold on. Oh. Wait, before we start asking some very sensitive questions, I think, do we want those other people hearing the answers to this?
Oh, that makes sense. One moment, and
okay, I pick it up again. And then, I pretend to do a little Heimlich on it.
Gone for a while,
in CPR,
right? And then, he comes back.
Stay in the line.
He's like, boom, just pops away. Okay, well,
put you on the table.
I'm at the back.
Are you in
of
a
the,
private place?
Well, I'm at the back of the boat. I can't really be anywhere else except on the deck.
I'm sure okay. it'll be okay.
We have a bit more important things to talk about other than the logistics of you on a boat. So just a quick crash course update. Our status of students at the school has been revoked partially by us voluntarily after things got hostile there from the Inquisitors and the Dean and Seekers. And so we are... fleeing. We are refugees at the moment.
And the Dean killed one of our friends.
Zendar. You met him.
Yeah.
I did. And this little creature leans over and puts a little hand on yours.
Put it on my finger.
Little titty head, right? Are you alright, Astrid?
I'm okay, but he's not.
We did not know it was this bad. No one... knew it was this bad.
And we met someone, we tried to leave and immediately was found by someone named the Warden who talked about the line. Do you know what that is?
Yes.
Can he hurt us?
The line are powerful. They are mortals that have acquired much power through magic and items. And some,
I hate magic and items.
Perhaps even some artifacts.
Even worse.
With this power, they seek to keep the gods and demigods in line, so that a god's war can never happen again.
In their line?
Oh, the line. That makes sense.
So they are the police.
The convention in this world is...
They're the po-po?
They are the police.
They are the police.
Jeez.
Okay. Did they think they're going to hurt us? Are they aiming to hurt?
I have not known them to be purposefully aggressive without reason. However, their reasons are found sometimes quite easily.
Do they work for anybody?
No, they are independent. Well, they have sponsors, certainly. But they're independent, as far as anyone officially knows.
Like, the school doesn't...
They have nothing to do with these... They will work with them. They have ties to the Seekers because they tend to be looking for the same people.
I mean, yeah, if the Forgotten are the ones stirring trouble, of course they're going to try to find
them. They're looking for them.
Yeah, I mean, if there's an establishment that's keep demigods in line, I'm sure a thing called the Line, who's trying to do that, would support that establishment.
Clearly the Warden and Dima, like, went to high school together or something.
But well, do they know about the Union, though? Would they allow that to even happen?
Do you know that?
Do you know about the Union?
Well, yeah, you must have gone through it, right? You're a demigod.
I did.
You went through the Union?
I did. It changes with each that goes through it. Rooms completely become different obstacles, different threats. There's no real way of using what I learned to help you all, because your rooms will be different. Your challenges will be different.
We're not going to do it.
Can you help us?
They're using demigods to feed it or power it or something.
When demigods die there, then it fuels some sort of weapon. It, like, siphons the life force of the demigods.
The school is harvesting demigods.
The school is harvesting demigods.
Did you know this, Steelbeard?
No. For what purpose?
I assume only Barros knows. He's the one that made it, right?
We got two baddies on our list. We got Barros, and we got Chaos. We have some insight from the future, which is something I kind of thought I would never have to say.
Yeah.
That told us that... Both those are, or iterations of the God of Order and the God of Chaos have stirred up quite the clusterfuck in the future.
You have information from the future.
A little girl visited us in each of our dreams.
Yeah, she claimed to be the goddess of dreams.
Ocarus came to you.
The future god of dreams.
Yeah.
Ocarus is dead in 5 years.
So will all of us.
Everyone.
Sorry.
You too.
This is a lot.
Yeah.
Hey, join the party.
Yeah.
You have faith in this.
I think... So I actually don't. I'm kind of the one that says that I have a friend here that can insert dreams into people's minds. But it is aligned with every other bullshit thing that has been going on.
And I want to believe it until it proves itself not to be true, you know? Because we have nothing else to believe. She's at least nice.
It seems,
yeah. She talked to us. She believed in us. She trusted us. Nobody else gives a shit to do that.
And it seems a bit risky not to treat this as serious, no matter what.
Yeah. I mean, if we just ignore it, it'll destroy us.
Yeah.
All right.
She did a kindness. Who knows what that could have... I mean, that... The power it must have taken to come back to us. I can't imagine what it could have done. Oh, she's just really, really powerful.
Yeah. All right. Here's what I will do. There are those I can speak to. I will try and get more information. Send for me again when you need me, and I will share what I have learned. It is dangerous for us to continue talking this way now, though.
What do we do now, though?
Where are you?
We're just in a forest.
A little bit north of the temple.
Yeah.
Stay out of sight of major cities. Be careful. I will contact you again soon. Yes.
Do you know what might be south of the temple?
There's much south of the temple. What are you looking for?
Well, Caitlin gave us gifts of some sort. And Barb, you got the compass, right?
I'm Barb, yeah.
Yeah. she gave them a compass that points south, and it seems to have a godstone, and then we think it might lead somewhere, but I've never been that far south. I don't know what's down there.
There are cities south. There's the desert south. But aside from that, just old battlefields and graveyards.
Well, we're going to go check it out because the alternative would be sitting here and waiting for Irondorf to come kiss our butts again. So. Yeah.
All right. Just be careful.
Yeah, you too. Are you going to come back?
Yes. As soon as I have any information, I will.
Where do you normally stay rooted? You're on a boat.
Yes. Originally, and he would explain that he's originally from the Northern Ironwood, the original Ironwood. And
where is that?
That's like way north. So you guys are on the southern continents, and then there's northern continents as well. So there's a whole other section. Yeah.
So he's not close.
No,
like
he's not close
at all. Closer to Ani and Raizan?
Exactly. Okay. Very close to Ani. Okay. Yeah.
So you're headed back north?
I am indeed. And there's people I can talk to there. I will send out birds as well.
Oh gosh! Make sure they're chill. Like
this
calm.
One that you sent, it flew past us.
Yes. Okay.
Do you not have a license or something?
Steven is a bit excitable.
Steven.
We'll have a conversation.
Do you ever feel weird that your name is Steelbeard and that everyone else's name is Steven?
No. Why?
Okay. Never mind.
Can we keep Steven?
Well, I mean, you can try.
Oh, hell yeah.
A lot of people have tried to keep Steven.
Steven can't be locked down. Steven's afraid of commitment, baby.
No one really owns Steven.
Steven's a free bird.
Steven. So, is there anything else then? I have much to do.
Yeah, I guess not.
Have you... One last question. Have you ever met Barrows?
No, not personally. I know some who have dealt with him.
I assume bad stories, right?
Everything I have heard is unpleasant.
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool. Just wanted to ask.
Okay.
Wish I had better news.
No, it's okay.
It was good to see you all. Please, take care.
Give my little finger. Yeah.
And then, like, as it's looking in your eyes, you know, a Steelbeard leaves, and the thing just starts to flex backwards and shake and tremble, and then like it screams a little bit, and then it just bursts to like splinters.
That was horrifying.
Why?
That's horrifying.
And then after this happens, I turn around and see the 10 other demigods in a circle staring at us as they were here this whole time. And they were like, the main characters are talking, let them speak.
Is the Steven Bird spell with a V or a PH?
PH.
Stephen?
No, because then it's Stefan. It's definitely a V. Okay. Also because a V looks like a bird.
Okay. I'm going to write that in my
PH
notes.
PH is also V as well.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Stephen.
Stephen.
I do like the idea of some of the demigods there because there was so much commotion at that point. So they were just standing there waiting for everything to happen.
I hope Malvorn wasn't listening.
I think he wasn't.
I mean, it was a big enough commotion.
He would have heard us talking about his daddy.
It's Varrock. And Varrock's just like, what the fuck?
Oh, we didn't tell anybody.
Yeah.
We shouldn't have.
What was that?
Don't worry about it.
It's a bird. It's named Steven.
What was this? Guys, that was weird. I look around. Is Malvorn here?
No.
Thank God.
Good. It was only for
It's a bird. Do you want a pet bird?
But what was that little tree thing?
Oh, that's my uncle? I don't know.
It's your godparent?
Your god.
No, it's not my godparent, but it's...
What?
Well,
in
our world, it would be your godparent because there was someone that was asked to look over you. They didn't give birth to you.
Yeah.
Oh, you're an elf and you come from trees.
Yes.
Yeah, but she didn't. She gave him the sky tree.
Right.
This is an earth tree.
Yeah, it's a, I don't know.
How many trees did you come from?
Good question for
her. Who knows? I don't know. I didn't think I even came from a tree.
That was your tree?
Maybe.
The little piece of wood that was screaming in pain and exploded?
Yes. Oh. It's a small version of a bigger tree that is my tree, probably. I think.
Is he okay?
Yeah, I think he's fine. I think the little version just exploded. I can put it back together, maybe. I don't know. It probably won't talk. But...
I'm not sure that's any less disturbing.
Okay.
So, and this kind of looks around at
I pat him on the back. Are you okay, Varrock?
I think so.
Okay.
You all are fine.
We're all fine.
You're so sweet, Brooke.
We just want to make sure that you don't say anything to certain people.
Can you take the memory out of what he heard out of his brain?
Will you do that for us? Will you just make sure not to say anything to certain people?
Are you supposed to take it out?
Yes, take it out. Take it right out.
What do I roll? What do I roll for you, Men in Black?
We need to plan we're gonna tell them and when we're gonna tell them. We can't. We definitely didn't even think to look like around us though.
A thought extraction. So it's a wisdom saving throw.
All right. That's gonna be a 12.
Save DC was a 15.
Yeah.
So I say,
yakety yak, baby.
You don't recall anything, right, from that conversation?
Yakety yak. Don't hold back. Yakety yak.
What conversation?
Right. We were just having breakfast, and I pull it and I cuff it in my hand.
We were having breakfast.
You're having.
We were going to have breakfast.
Yeah, you're a big boy. You need a lot to eat.
Yeah, there's not much on this ship to eat, sadly.
No, let's go find you some breakfast.
Okay, let's go eat.
Okay.
All right. Excellent.
We're good.
Barb looks at Janice wide-eyed. Whoa. From the moral implications of that.
Mortified.
Almost like, holy shit.
Did I not tell you I could do that?
Janice says, it's like, listen, it's fine. Don't even worry about it. It's
my name? I don't even know who I am anymore.
Janice, have you ever done that to us? Would we know?
No, I don't. I have never done it to you. I promise I would say.
Now Varrock's going to ask what we're talking about.
Varrock left. You went to go look for breakfast.
Okay.
Yeah. It's all fine. Don't worry. I'm learning about my power set like all of you. So this is all new to me as well.
That's wild.
That's amazing, but also kind of horrifying.
Well,
I knew you could put things in, but I didn't know you could pull things out. That's so interesting.
Oh, yeah. Goes one way, you can pull it right back out. Yeah.
Ooh,
this is
that.
You grow bones out of your body and throw them at people.
Yeah, but the mind's fragile. I don't know.
It's the most sensitive part of the body.
I promise you, Varrock is okay. It didn't hurt him. He has no recollection of anything. Wow. It's all right here.
Okay.
We do need to tell them eventually, but I feel like I want more answers before I tell them the world's gonna end, you know?
Well, I think regardless, we've decided that we're gonna follow this great, cool compass.
Head south.
Yeah.
But graveyards.
Ask why? We have 10 other people who are gonna ask why we're heading south.
I'll talk to them about
that. Are they?
Are we? What about Wendell? I feel kind of bad that we are so close to his home. He doesn't get to see his mom.
I worry that he'd be.
He doesn't need to come along with us.
Protect him.
I don't think any of the fans like him.
I'd be worried that I couldn't protect him if he's with his mother. Like, what if he gets attacked and he can't fend for himself?
That's what moms are for.
Do you think that Wendell would be tempted to stay with his mother if we went to go see her?
Let's ask him. This kid can make decisions.
I think
he
would want to stay with his mother, yeah.
Then maybe we just go.
Maybe we should pose that question to everybody, because what we're about to do could put them in even more risk. Give them a choice to stay with us or go.
Is there a bell I can ring anywhere?
Sure.
Thanks. I ring the bell that forms out out of the air.
You don't need to ring a bell. Your bell is your bell is right here. You want everybody?
We know.
Ring my bell.
I reach over and I ring the bell.
Ring my bell.
A couple minutes later,
a drag queen comes out and rings my bell.
Everyone's walked out and assembled. Wendell is dragging a blanket while
Bubby.
Malvorn is perfectly immaculately ready.
Son.
Who gives a shit? Only describe Malvorn when we ask.
Whoa, this is going hard. Harder than I usually do.
I kind of shit Malvorn and Barb now.
What?
It's the opposite.
Barbmorn?
No
Barborn?
Balvorn.
Marb.
Anyway, first of all, I'm glad you all reacted to that bell in a way that I wanted you to, even though we didn't rehearse that. I'm glad. I'm guessing some things are universal.
One take.
Number one. Number two. Just thought we could have a little group powwow here and give you an update on what's the plan. Who wants to go south? Show of hands.
Everyone kind of looks at each other. And like one or two of them put a hand up. The rest of them are just kind of confused.
Yeah, so East Red, as you may know us, or as we're officially called, the Yakety Pack, we have some business down south, and we would love it if anyone wants to join along. But also, live your life. Do whatever you want. If you want to get off this ship right now, the cops are probably going to come back. That's my only tidbit of advice. But you're free to do so. I look at Wendell and I say, Wendell, I heard that your town is just a little bit that way. Might be nice to see your mom. Totally support that.
Wendell kind of looks out the window, almost expecting to be able to see it right,
not yet,
the window.
Not yet, but yeah.
And let it be said that I genuinely feel like I'm invested in all of your well-beings at this point. I feel like we are some of the only people that are invested in our own well-beings right now. And I do want you to make your own decisions and leave if you feel that is your path, but I worry about your safety outside of numbers, because the temple was our safety as we thought, and it wasn't as safe as we thought. And I'm hoping we can just find another place to punker down and figure everything out so we're not living in a ship anymore. But if you want to go to your own home, I understand that, but your safety cannot be guaranteed. Which...
Yeah, whether you stay with us or go anywhere else.
Yep. I would say that we might be just a little bit more dangerous.
Probably.
But there is safety in being together.
Yes. Varrock, yeah.
This makes sense.
Okay.
And Varrock looks at Malvorn. And Malvorn gives a little nod. He's like, yes, he agrees. There's safety in numbers. But seems to resent it.
Okay. So, show of hands, anyone that wants to have a little goodbye right now, we can exchange numbers and just keep in touch.
Kailu's hand goes up.
All right.
And that's it. Only Kailu's.
Kailu.
Aran, we were giving you an opportunity to not have to voice 10 characters.
I know, but I thought
it's really
about...
Right. It's like 9, so this will take it to 8.
I thought about all their motivations, and the Kailu's the only
like
one that wants to bail,
All right, Kailu. Hey, you make bomb-ass tea.
And
where do you want to go, Kailu?
Kailu stops at he's already kind of thrown his pack on and is ready to walk out.
I mean, we didn't
have
a bedroom, so now he's just like, bye.
Yeah, he's done. He's like, I'm gonna go. And so he stops and he waves a hand over the edge of the ramp, and a bunch of these tea leaves just grow in a huge kind of horseshoe all around where the ramp is at, and he just gestures to them. Enjoy.
Oh. Is that tea for us?
Nods. All right. Starts walking down the ramp.
All right. Not much of a talker this way.
He never has been.
Can I walk over to Wendell?
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
Just look at the little porthole looking out.
And I put my hand on his shoulder and I say, I'm glad you want to stay. Because I like you.
And he leans back. He's like, well, I like you too, Astrid.
But do you want to maybe visit your mom before we go? I can ride you on Luna. We can go down and say hi and let her know you're okay. And.
No. This was hard enough for her. It was tough. She's going to be really worried if she finds out what happened now. We'd have to tell her.
We would?
What else would? How else would we explain being there?
Just say it's field a little vacation.
Trip.
Yeah, a little
field trip.
Yeah. Well, we don't even have to see her. We could just go look, and she doesn't have to know we're there. And you can see her, and then we can come back.
Okay.
I don't know. Okay. I don't want to put my intentions on you. I know I'd like to see my dad's, but
you.
I don't know. You don't have to if it's too hard.
I have an idea.
Okay.
You can see through Luna, right? You told me you can see through her. What if we bridge and then I can see through Luna?
Is that possible?
I don't know. Maybe.
Let's try it.
Yay!
Yeah, we can. We could try. Pull out the keys.
Yeah. So,
I'm trying to see if I can give myself any advantage or anything at all.
Before you, you can bridge, or maybe I can help.
Okay.
Okay.
What can you do?
I could possibly put you in the Mind Palace.
Okay.
And put your mother in there if you want to talk to her that way.
Oh, wait, we don't think we want to talk to her. We just want to see her, right?
Yeah, I don't want to put my mom in the Mind Palace.
He doesn't want her to know what happened.
Because she'll be scared.
Yeah. Okay.
But thank
Bridging it is. I walk out of the
airship. I retreat to a safe distance.
Let's go outside just to make sure.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So let's go outside. We're going to get like a safe distance, 30 feet away from the airship.
Yeah, yes. So Wendell's just a crack in his neck.
Oh, gosh.
He
this is terrifying.
Carefully takes his pouches off so that flip, flap, and...
The other one's not around, right?
I kind of
flip and flap, and then flop was the third.
Oh, yeah, what happened?
That evaporated.
Because it was created by the temple.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It wasn't really real.
Yeah.
And so one day, and this would have been like off camera, but Wendell just realized real quick that they weren't there because the otters flipped out. And they were freaking out because they couldn't find little one. And then Wendell started crying, and you talked him down. And
yeah, I probably would have given him a big old hug and let him cry.
Yeah, he was pretty upset, but realized in the end that it wasn't real.
We can find another
Barb
one.
Barb realizes that all of the food that they ate was fake, and the nutrition they got so that was in their body and bones
and they all
was
just
all evaporated. And every single demigod at the same time threw up because of malnutrition.
That was a wild hour that we had last night.
That was a wild episode. That's a gold tier Patreon. The PC's thrown up.
But yeah, that probably happened. But he's a demigod of otters. I'm sure we can get some more otters. Maybe. I don't know.
Come on.
Make a new
otter. Let's do it.
Let
him breed.
Dad. It's like, what? This puppy looks just like this other puppy.
Oh no! No, my poor buddy. Okay, yeah. I wish I could think of any way to help myself, but I think it's just a straight up D20, baby.
D20 plus your divinity,
which is shit because it's charisma.
12.
17.
That's going to do it. Yeah, you guys form a bridge, and you are now resonating with each other's energy, and you can feel each other's divinity flowing through both of you. And you are instantly connected with Luna. Luna, you know, perks up and runs over, and it's weird because, like, you see through Luna's eyes, but runs right to your face, so the nose is in your face, and there's, like, all of a sudden a tongue licking your face,
this
but it's
weird.
You're
I
in
this.
The... Yeah.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Luna, darling, you know what Wendell smells like. He's our friend. Find his smell in that town.
Find the origin of
Or do
that
you know
smell.
Can you lead her maybe in some way to
Do you have something that your mother
and just boom takes off.
Okay, I'll hold Wendell's hand while we look through Luna's eyes.
You know, a little bit uncomfortable, but eventually
I'll
gets
try to help
used it to
like
it.
Help make him feel less disoriented.
Whoa. Wow. She's fast.
She's very fast.
Oh, there's the river that goes beyond our house, and there's the stone wall. Oh, there's the windmill. Oh, I haven't been home in a while. I missed it. I haven't been gone this long ever.
Yeah, 4 days. It's the longest the kid's ever been gone.
Wow.
Luna, throw a rock at the stone wall.
And so then Luna, like, slows down and, like, kind of gets behind some bushes and crouches down and, like, peeks around the edge. And you can see the same house that you that you saw earlier. And there is a woman out front. Looks like the same woman you saw before. Yeah, right.
Thank
She's
God.
Alive. Yeah.
I was so worried. I was so worried she'd be dead.
Just hanging up. There's a lot of people in black, and they look sad.
I was like, Rob, no.
So
got me for. You see the fear in my eyes that just shot out. I was like,
how do I kill a Rob this way?
I know. I'm holding Wendell's hand, and he'd just be like. It just cries. Yeah,
this
never
collapses. Who are they, Astrid? I don't understand. Why are you so sad?
They're your mom's new boyfriends.
Good
for her.
No, okay, so she's just by herself?
Yeah, it's like, weird. Oh, there, oh, yeah, that's Mom. And she's, like, hanging up wash, and she puts up a couple of blankets and towels, and then she picks up her basket, and she turns, and there's this huge scar down the right side of her face that goes into her neck. It's, you know, healing, but it's still red and puffy, and there's, like, some bandages down by her neck that, you know, are clearly, they're fresh, but even then there's a little bit of blood, you know, that has leached into them. And Wendell just, like, freaks out and,
it's okay.
And like, pushes backward, and he just vanishes from inside. He just pops out. The bridge separates. You can remain in the
I'll
wolf.
I'll stay with Luna.
Okay. So you're with Luna, and you can, like, hear Wendell crying a little bit around
it's
you.
It's okay, buddy. It's okay.
Yeah.
And I try to I tell Luna to go to his mom.
Wait.
Go to her.
And
go, just...
Okay, so... Yeah. So...
Just approach.
Just steps out and, like, shows themselves, and the woman screams and throws her basket in the air and runs inside.
She's outside! They're
it's
not animals.
A dire wolf!
She's gorgeous. So. She's a beautiful dire wolf.
Look, bears are really pretty. There are some pretty bears. I'm not going to hang.
Is there... What's, like, around Luna? Are there, like, flowers in the field? Like, are
a,
there...
A mustache and a top hat that Luna can put on.
There's all the laundry that she dropped.
There's laundry.
Can she yank, like, one of the flowers up with her mouth?
Okay, while you're doing that, I need you to roll a stealth.
She doesn't need to be sneaky about it.
No, I mean, there's Astrid? Other people that could... No, there's other people that could see Luna.
Oh, so Luna has to roll a stealth?
Yeah.
Well, and she did yell. She did scream.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
No, 7.
Oh, I rolled a 3.
Okay.
So you got lucky. So there are some flowers, sure.
I'm going to yank one out of the ground.
Sure.
And go up to the, just where the, what am I trying to say, where the door is. Does any of the, like, I just wanted to leave the flower by the door.
Okay, so just gently puts this flower down. By the door.
Yeah. And just do like a little scratch, scratch, and then run away.
It scratches at the door. That's another scream from inside.
I don't think of Luna as like scary.
Luna runs away.
You just scratch the W.
I wondered. Well, I was like, I don't know. I just wanted to know she's, I don't know.
In
Morse,
whatever. We know what you want.
Could Luna knock out in Morse code, I'll be back?
Yeah. No, I wanted her to know in some way that Wendell is okay, and I was just like, I don't know how to do that.
He's a dire wolf.
Hey, everyone, judge me at the table, please. I'm just trying to help this poor little boy. I love him so much. Yeah, I guess I didn't think of her scary, because no one else has ever been like worried about her.
Because you've been around demigods the whole game.
But still, yeah. I mean, all these people have been normal until they found out they were demigods.
Well, Malvern's a little afraid of her, I'll tell you that.
Well, good, he should, because she ripped his throat out.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes, exactly. Exactly our point.
Before she was a dire wolf, too.
Yeah, she wasn't even leveled up. Like, she just fucking did that shit.
So, are we assuming that came from when she was like.
It looked fresh. And
probably
it's only
when
been
she,
4 days.
Something attacked her.
So, yeah.
Something attacked her.
Yeah.
Huh.
Did it. Could I.
Maybe we should go and talk
and
to her.
I'm just gonna think this thought before I go comfort Wendell. Based on the scratches and my like sort of experience with like animals and nature, did it look like an animal scar?
Roll knowledge of nature.
Okay. Knowledge of nature. The skill.
Fuck, 7.
What is your favorite your favorite target with like what's the ranger thing?
What?
Your favorite enemy.
Favorite enemy?
Thank you.
Oh, monstrosities.
Roll with advantage.
Oh, fuck. Okay. Yep. 10. This dice isn't doing well. I have to get rid of it.
So it's what you can tell is that from the brief glance you got through the eyes of a wolf is that it's definitely not like a weapon. It's not a clean cut.
It's like a creature did
it's
that.
It's definitely something animal.
Would I know it's not a dire wolf? Like, a dire wolf didn't do that, right?
If a dire wolf clawed her face,
she would have been dead. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought it might just be, like, a very, whoops, PTSD thing I just did to her. But it's not. Okay, I'll pop out. I'll tell Luna to come back. No. And then I'll pop out and go to Wendell, I guess. Right. Is he on the ground? Is he?
Yeah, he's on the ground. He's got his knees up into his chest and his head buried in them.
It's okay. She's fine.
She's not.
She was doing laundry and
And something cut her face open?
I guess so, darling. I don't know, but she's alive. That's what's important.
If I'd been there, I could have stopped it.
How would you have stopped it? Tell me.
I could have stopped it.
Yeah?
Yeah. I've learned a lot in the temple so far.
In the 2 days?
Yeah, well, it's a lot.
I know.
I did okay.
No, you did great.
Barb comes out to the mouth of the airship and says, "Hey."
Yeah.
Are plans changing?
Do you want to go see your mother? She's okay. She's alive. I'll be a little scared now, but...
She'll just be in more danger. I don't want her in any more danger.
That's true. And when all is said and done, we can go back. We can go back to her. I promised you I would.
Oh, I am going back to her.
Yes.
I'm going to make them let me go back to her. I'll summon so many otters.
Can you send an otter to watch after her? Kind of like Luna, but like with an otter, I guess.
Well,
is that
maybe,
possible?
Maybe. And he gets
just up. Just a little watch otter that maybe you can use to check in with her or something.
Walks over to the river, right? That's nearby, that runs behind his house. And he tries.
I'm going to give him advantage somehow with my love.
Well, I'm just going to say that at some point Wendell got inspiration.
Sure.
Fuck the rules.
That's going to be 16.
If it's narratively cool, let's get lit, baby. Yep.
I'm spending my inspiration. And 16 like kind of reaches down and like puts his hands into the river and like sinks them down deep into the riverbed, and then reaches off to the side and gathers a piece of just wood that's fallen down nearby and places that on top and just starts packing the mud in around this piece of wood until he's got roughly the shape of an otter. And then just one swipe with his hand over it, and poof, there's an otter right there that wriggles out of his hand. Like seemingly he's holding mud, and it just is, all of a sudden is alive. Wriggles out of his hands and into the water, just splashing around.
What's the name?
And
weird flip, weird flap, weird flop.
We want to know what your name is.
Flap.
Floop.
Flap.
Flounder.
Flounder. Yeah, maybe you can send Flounder to keep an eye out on your mother, and then you'll know she's safe.
Listen, my mom's in trouble, and she's really great. And I can't stay here and look out for her because it'll just make her be in more trouble and possibly sad. And so I wanted to know if you wouldn't mind, would you look out for her for me? You will? He'll do it. And then splash, splash, splash. Actually,
this is the most child friendly we've ever been.
No, first it like pops up, like it, yeah. like.
Oh yeah, high five!
Right? Yeah. High five! High five!
Flounder
takes off.
That's cool. I didn't know you could do that.
Well,
did you make them? And I point at Flip and Flap.
No, and they found me. They're different. They're real.
Oh.
They came to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Astrid. Yeah. No.
No, we're gonna keep going south.
Okay. Yeah. And I run back in. You hear me yell, "Ronald McDonald!"
Like walks out. Ren kind of looks at you, you know, because you were definitely calling Red, right?
Yeah, Ronald. Yeah.
No, Ronald McDonald.
Ronald
we want
McDonald.
The Ronald McDonald in this airship.
Hi, kids.
No. I take it back.
We stab it.
We show the dog.
Want me to start up the airship?
Yes.
Of course.
Yes.
Wait, were you Goofy from like?
I was. You'd like kind of switched into Goofy. Yeah.
Gorsh. Yeah. All right.
Wake me up. Let's start up.
Rev up them engines.
Okay, it'll take an hour.
Well, fuck, Ronald.
We should have started that
this?
An hour ago.
I tried to start it an hour ago.
I know.
We'll start it now.
We were calling a tree.
All right. So he goes down to the engine room, and there's some clanking and banging, and steam gusts out from the sides of the ship. And 40 2 minutes later.
Oh, jeez.
He's telling them to ramp.
42 or 43?
42. 44 when the ramp's up.
Yeah.
So he comes out from the boiler room just soaked in sweat because it is hot down there and calls for the ramp to be raised.
The ramp says, okay.
All aboard.
Let's get south.
And all right. He takes the console. Malvorn has been in his scribe pad trying to make
it
work.
How does it keep working?
He puts it back into the console, and that's when it works. But again, only with the systems of the airship and nothing else. And there's no, like, worldwide internet or anything, you know? Yeah.
Yet.
And the ship lifts off, and you all start flying south.
Real quick, I walk up to Astrid, and I'm like, hey, I didn't mean to, like, interrupt.
It's okay.
I mean, I obviously did, but that wasn't my...
It's okay. He was just having a rough time.
Are you sure he's good staying with us?
I think he is. I think he honestly made a really mature decision. Honestly, I'm proud of him. And, but his mother... I think I told you, right, about the time I viewed her on the scrypad?
Yeah.
And I was worried about her. She had some sort of scarring on her face, and that's what made him freak out a little bit. And
well, hell.
It looked... It came from a creature. It wasn't a weapon or a sword or anything. It came from something. So that is a little scary.
Yeah.
But I don't know if we can detour for it right now. I don't think Wendell wants to.
Yeah.
But, it's fine. You didn't interrupt. I know we need to go, but I know I'd want to check in with my dads if I was this close, so yeah, I wanted to give him that choice.
Is Theodore around? Theodore, are you around? Theodore?
Yeah.
hey.
It's been 42 minutes. I was probably helping Renault.
Yeah, probably.
Sort of, like, trying to learn this airship.
Totally.
What's the radius on those goggles of yours again?
I don't think I can judge it, but 2 miles.
Sounds like 2 miles.
Far, yeah.
We're getting up in the air right now, right?
Yes, correct.
Do you want to just, like, see, like, scan around and see if you can see where Kylie went? I'm just curious what direction he went.
Oh, yeah, sure. And I, like, kind of just adjust them on my face and look for Kylie.
Roll perception.
Oh, damn, Kylie was our vine.
Yeah. Hold it with advantage.
Oh, wait. For
for dangling.
Your Doppler,
yep.
Damn thing.
It. Everyone got rid of it.
Which would apparently work, because that's why I got rid of it. It's annoying.
12?
Yeah, you just... He must have moved quick, because he's already, like, either he went somewhere else and you guys are flying away from each other, mm-hmm. or he just moved quickly, because there's no sight of him.
I mean, it's been 45 minutes. You can run 2 miles in 45 minutes, so...
Yeah. Okay.
Also heavy tree...
foliage
cover in this area, mm-hmm. and he could probably just swing from vine to vine. Yeah.
So we're we're gonna follow the compass, but do we skirt around the school because that's heading back in the direction of the school?
Yeah, I think we should.
The compass takes you straight over it.
Can we tell Renault to try to
skirt around?
Yeah.
Yep. So the school sits in this narrow strip between two continents and above a valley.
Okay.
So the valley is below it, and this is on like a floating island above it. There's several other floating islands, and they're connected with bridges and such, right? So there are cliffs at the edge, and then just sea. So you can easily skirt to the side, or even maybe down, so that they couldn't because the cliff faces are a couple hundred feet tall. So you could actually dip down and around and dip back up.
Is that safe?
There's a lot of winds around the cliff sides. I mean, is it as safe as flying high over? No. I mean, you can't go too high, of course, because the winds get too high. But if you fly over and up, you can be seen.
Yeah.
If you fly around and up, you can be seen. If you fly down, it's a much better chance not to be seen, but the winds are dangerous. It's a difficult maneuver with a blimp.
Could we, like, travel through the clouds or, like, this?
That high? Can't go that high.
Can't go that high?
Yeah.
What's wrong with just, like, a curve?
Nothing.
I mean, other than sight.
Other than that,
yeah.
I'm okay with that, Ronald. Okay. I'd rather do more time than being seen by people that want to see us.
Okay. Then that is the plan. And they both kind of like, do navigation. Malvorn leans over and like he sets in a couple of things and pulls a couple of switches, and Malvorn, without saying a word, just sighs and
turns off two of them to back to where they were and just glares at them and goes back because he thinks he's right.
Perfection, yeah.
Should we like install the compass in the like
display?
Yeah, I got it. Hold on. I take it out of my pocket like, and I put it on the dashboard.
Does it need to be there?
I would like you to roll perception, Nikki.
Oh.
Roll investigation.
Because we need them to follow it.
13.
Okay. There is a little impression, which is like, the bottom of a seashell.
Caitlin, you sneaky little girl.
But I didn't know the compass was seashell shaped, is it?
It's like a clamshell, right?
Mm-hmm. We made a joke about it.
Yeah. So the bottom impression would be like a seashell, yeah.
Okay.
O'Neill Jones coming in clutch with that van art.
Great. Yeah.
I love your art.
How do we know we're going, we're in the destination that we're supposed to go to? Like,
will it do the thing where it like spins around all crazy? I don't know.
I put it in. What does it do?
All right. So you place the seashell into it. Is it open or closed?
I open it.
Okay, so you place the seashell in and you open
the
it.
The most heavy
weighted. What if it like
then
points north or like a different
move I've ever done?
As soon as you open it, the thing begins to glow brighter and brighter, the needle, and there's a loud like and there's an increased amount of steam. The propellers spin up a little bit more. The ship shifts back towards left and starts cutting straight south.
So it's driving itself?
Oh, it's driving.
Yeah, as they're pulling at it, it's not doing anything.
Oh, shit. I take that out.
It's stuck.
Oh, my gosh. It's going to take us right over the temple.
So this word stuck means very little to Barb. I'm going to form bones around my fingers and start trying to
You
claw
wish you were wearing
out.
Those strength
I would
braces
like you to,
right now.
I would like you to roll a strength roll.
Are you wearing your braces?
Yeah. But
no. I thought you left.
I thought they put them on.
Bracelets? No, I keep the bracelets on.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
My arrows are under my bed.
The useless bracelets that they'll never use.
I mean, not any of my attack rolls. Shoot.
You need them for all these clamshell
19.
19. Okay.
Don't
so,
need that fucking bracelet.
So you pull and pull and pull, and I would like you to call high or low.
Oh, gosh. We don't want to break this.
What's
the point of that fucking 19?
If this shit falls out of the sky, I will die.
High or low?
High.
So you
That's good, right?
feel the lid beginning to separate, and you're able to adjust just a little bit and grab it by the edge of it, and pop, it pulls off. There's a slamming like the blades immediately cut, the steam explodes out the sides, the whole ship kind of shifts and lurches everyone forward and then swings back.
Can I hear what Janice is sounding like while this is happening? Sorry, I saw RV desperate desperately wanting to act out this scene.
The physicality RV just did. I've never wanted a GIF more in my life than RV's body flailing like it just was. That is so.
It is.
I love it.
Everything okay?
Yeah. I have the compass in my hand and I'm like, okay.
Did you break it?
So this belongs to the ship.
To this ship.
This goes with the ship.
But it will drive us straight through?
Yes. So I'm just going to use it like a normal compass because that's what it is.
Wait, we have maps here. Yeah. It's not that hard
maybe
to navigate.
Once we get past the temple, we can pop it in and then let it drive us there.
Ronald, it's...
So that'll be in an hour and a half, 2 hours?
Yeah,
when we get past the temple?
Just right now, take a sharp right turn.
All
right. Right curve, right hook.
Swings back to the right again and is plotting a course basically going west of the temple and then going to swing back around.
I flip on the switches that Malvorn thought were supposed to be off.
Okay.
Because what the fuck does Malvorn know? This
He knows how to drive
his
them.
His daddy has 17 of
these.
Didn't he say he knew how to drive?
Yeah, he knows how to drive.
He knows how to drive these.
Okay, I flipped them off.
Do you know how to drive them?
No. Well, I thought Ronald.
I'm proficient in land vehicles.
I thought Ronald was more of the expert here.
Ronald kind of oversold
Yeah.
How much experience.
I think he's figuring it out.
We don't have an airship at the fort. That's not Rhizon tech.
No.
Well, you could have told me that.
So I would say then it's going to be a bit about 2 hours for you guys to swing all the way around. So you guys are getting south. It's a bright, clear day. You guys swing out south over the ocean. The ocean is calm and peaceful, and you catch just, you know, you're catching a glimpse of the temple as you're kind of dipping down.
They can't see us at all.
What do you,
can you scope that shit?
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
If we're close enough, I'm going to look.
Yeah.
2 miles?
Yeah, totally.
That's not that far. How far away are we?
2 miles is pretty far.
Two miles is not that far. Super far.
Yeah. It's only 16 blocks.
He can read a he could read a stop sign or pick out a face at 2 miles. So he can still get a nice close view.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I'm saying I don't want us to be that close to the temple.
Even if you were further than 2 miles, he could still get a far closer view and get an idea of what's going on.
What's going on now.
Yeah. Might have been a pick at a face or...
I'm just spooked. Okay?
No,
I
get it.
I'm just spooked, okay?
I would like
the dean still flailing around shooting shit.
Fireworks everywhere.
You have enough time for 2 perception rolls as you dip down, and you'll have enough time for 2 more when you dip back up.
I thought we were going around.
We stopped the dip. It's a super, you know, they land super, you know, super wide, and then it becomes not so wide, so you dip down.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so 4 rolls?
Well, right now, just 2.
That's a 19.
Okay.
That's a 7.
Okay. So, with the 19, here's what you see on the way down. There are seekers out in front of every building. So, every entrance has a seeker guard, and there's other seekers that are walking the perimeter. Every seeker is wearing a hat. And on the front of those hats is an emblazoned eye.
What?
Okay.
Oh.
Teodor, what do you see?
Can I just say that I imagine them as like fezzes? But I know that's probably not what it is.
No, that is what it is.
I was thinking bowler hats.
Bowler hats?
Bowler? Like those
bowler hats. Yeah.
I love bowler hats.
Yeah. Yeah. Still, both very strange fashion choices, fezzes and bowler hats for these intimidating
dudes. The dean loves his hats, right?
Yep. Wait, what if they're all different hats?
They're all different.
It seems like the majority of them, so you rolled a 19, so the majority of them are wearing these bowler hats, but when you see someone barking out orders or pointing and gesturing like they were in command, they all have an individual hat, like some unique hat picked out for them or they picked out.
Oh my.
This world went completely buck wild.
I think the dean has gone full bonkers.
I think there's a... We can't ever go in here again.
You also sorry.
No, I was just saying, we've got to face our consequences eventually.
Eventually, I don't think we're strong enough to deal with...
I'm not saying right now, but... We're not strong enough to deal with...
I can't help but assume that he's got them all under some sort of mind control at this point.
If that isn't just
wearing hats before when they came to get us.
If that's not a perfect opportunity for Janice to get in costume, I don't know what is. We've got to face it eventually. But
we'll burn that bridge when we get to it.
What else do I say?
We'll make that bridge.
Make that
with our divinities.
You see 3 sources of divine energy. One from the arena, one from the hospital, and then one from a building that you haven't seen on an island that you guys haven't investigated yet. You have enough time to focus on one. Which one do you want to focus
on? Oh, God.
So okay, wait.
I know what
the hospital we know is
Demrin.
The arena is... What is the... Where is the arena?
It's probably...
The arena is that big place you guys
keep going. That's probably the dean?
Probably the dean.
Because he's a demigod, so that means it's the third demigod. So by divine energy, you mean there's like demigod energy.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it could be god energy.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So maybe, yeah. I say the unknown one.
Yeah, which one? What does your gut say?
The gut would have looked in on Demrin to make sure that Demrin was okay.
Because my brain's like the one we haven't seen before.
I know.
Same.
But also...
But we'd love this role-playing. I support it.
Yeah, no. Do what Teodor would do. Because I doubt Teodor is like, okay, guys, I got 3 choices. Like, I assume you're just making the decision. Yeah.
I'm also curious to see if the tortoise is still there as well.
Right.
So yeah, he might be the one in the room we don't
You and if Alina got out.
Or...
Yep.
We also locked her.
Oh, yeah, Alina.
So you zip into the, or you refocus on the hospital. Roll me one investigation, please.
Oh, investigation's so much better. Perception's awful. I have none.
So the third building we had never seen before?
No, you'd seen it. You just hadn't invested. Like,
we don't know what was there.
Exactly.
22.
22?
Ooh, hell yeah.
Okay.
Theodore's an int, not a whiz.
Oh, yeah. You focus in, and you are able to like really get a good read in. These are starting to make a lot more sense to you. Mm-hmm. You see Tibor's energy, right? And then a moment later, you see Alina's energy.
Hmm.
And that's it.
Fuck.
Fuck.
And then you dip
down
beneath the thing. Yep.
You okay?
Guys.
What?
Demeron's not there.
What do you mean?
Demeron's not in the hospital.
Maybe
Alina's still there, and so is the tortoise.
Maybe they moved her.
Maybe? Is she okay, you think? Maybe she got better.
Could be.
Then she's there by herself.
They're probably interrogating her right now.
Fuck. She's not going to know anything, which is good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably safer for her, but...
Shit, I feel so bad.
I wish we could have gotten her. So because I can pick out divine or divinities.
Yes.
Were there only three? Is that what you meant by this? The divine light
there
source?
There were three sources of divine energy. Once you focused on the hospital, you were able to separate that into two distinctive divine energies.
So like the teachers and the other people.
Right, they could all be in like one
there?
Area.
There could be people there. There could be people layered up.
Okay, yeah, that's also not good. I'm sure there's something really bad.
Yeah, she could have been moved, but she's not good if she's still fragile, right?
Right.
Yeah. Listen, gang, this is just a motivation to tack on to when we're done with whatever the compass
is. Is the compass still pointing south even though we're nearing the temple? Is it pointing at the temple?
No, it's no, it's not. It's pointing past the temple. And as you swing out, it shifts a little bit. But not much. So clearly, whatever it's pointing to is a good distance.
The
yeah,
the temple is not our destination.
I thought I was like, he's just taking us right back to the temple.
We're really gonna play magical Harry Potter. It's fine.
Yeah, I will make you pay.
All right, we'll keep course curved for south.
All right.
I feel so bad.
I know. Me too.
Okay, so you all dip down, and now you're flying along the cliffside above this ocean. And again, it's a clear day, not a lot of wind, not a lot of waves, just a pleasant day.
How high are we, or how close are we to the ocean? Like
maybe 300 feet.
Okay.
It's not far.
It's not close, though. It's 3 football
As long as
feet.
We're not just, like, skirting it, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I assume we're just going to keep following the compass. Once we clear the temple, we can pop it in.
Yeah. So it'll be about an hour with this detour, and then you'll pop back up. You should get Theodore 2 more chances on
natty 20.
Yes. Natty 20.
And 18.
Okay. All right. So
fuck yeah.
Smart thing.
Yeah. Our smart son. I love him.
You know what you're looking for this time. So you focus on those two buildings right away. In the arena, you get Archon Mordok's energy.
Oh, God. What does that look like?
It's dark and twisted.
Seven types of hats all tied together.
Yes. It's a giant beanie, and the propeller's coming right
for
you. Yeah, it's dark and twisted and fractured.
Heartbroken by Astrid.
Yep, I dumped him. So.
You dumped him.
Yeah,
but anyone dumped him. But you were a special person that came and helped him. And
we didn't listen. We didn't have the talk.
They didn't have a talk with.
If anything, I'm just ghosting him right now.
They'll be back. I'll be back.
So, and then you definitely also see.
So he's the only one in the arena.
No, not yet.
You
definitely see Demrin's energy immediately afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
And then you see the energy from the demigod. Wait. What is her name?
Roswin.
Sorry.
Names.
Who? You see the energy from Roswin.
Oh, God. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
What about Dima?
No. Archon Dima is not in there. However, You do see Archon Dima's energy from the building that's farthest back. And you zoom
just
your eyes.
Just the three of those are in the arena, though?
Yes, just the three of those right now are in the arena. So you zoom all the way back, and you focus back in to try and figure out what that building is. And there's this, you know, huge, like, if it was a smaller proportion, you would call it a shed with a giant rolling door in the front. Okay. And it's been opened. And an airship, probably three times the size of yours, is half sticking out of this giant, what must be a hangar. It's tied down, and there's people running around, working on it, prepping it, getting it ready. And there's gouts of steam that keep blowing out of it. And every time a gout of steam blows out of it, you can see energy that is Dima? And you don't understand how it's tying together.
I thought he was on the R side.
Unless they're forcibly making him do it.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
So Dima's the only one that's in that in there?
As you're doing that, you hear yelling from the cockpit.
Our cockpit?
Yeah.
That cockpit. But also,
I do
want to say, they think we went north, and if we're skirting around sneakily to the south, they will go north to look for us, hopefully.
But they also have like 50 seekers.
That wasn't a character. I didn't have an accent.
I never break character. We can't
But that was my immediate thought before we get murdered. What's happening in the cockpit?
Screaming.
Oh. No, just some yelling. And in the cockpit, like
the bird yelling?
No, like Malvorn
yelling at
Malvorn and
Renault?
Ren are shouting at each other, and then Malvorn is shouting like, come here, look.
What's going on?
So you guys come up to the, all right, so Malvorn's scrypad has fuzzed out and then comes back in, and you can see Dima screaming, just howling, and he kind of like breaks apart into mist and then forms back into himself and breaks apart and forms back, and the whole time he's screaming.
They're torturing
and then
him.
It just separates
him.
And then it goes dead.
They're torturing him to make this fucking airship work.
He's their energy source.
That
to
is
make
so
that.
Fucked up.
Okay. Where are they getting this manpower?
The
like
Seekas.
Enforce all of this?
There's so many Seekas that we don't know about.
What is power? I'm sorry, I liked Bryant to an extent, but I always thought I could beat his ass.
True.
But 100 of them?
Sure.
I mean, yeah, surely, you know, some demigods could fight them in a battle, but, you know, the whole job of the Seekers is to take demigods, and they've done it for years and years and years, and they've been successful, so clearly
without
they have...
anybody even noticing!
Yeah, clearly they have some skills, and they have numbers, and they... And right now, they're not really... They outnumber the demigods right now at the temple. They took the numbers away.
And this is clear proof that the Dean has gone off the deep end. They're taking the teachers now and torturing them.
Renald, did you know anything about this? Like, about how the Seekers could maybe possibly be controlled by the Dean?
It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't... I know some of these people. They didn't like the Dean. Most of us were just kind of weirded out by him.
But you worked for the school. So whatever the school asked you and the Seekers, not necessarily you, but the Seekers, to do, you would have done.
Yeah, but why are they wearing different uniforms? And
maybe the Inquisitors?
Oh,
no.
Wait. Were the Inquisitors there? Did you see their energy?
He did not.
So the Inquisitors left.
They're probably looking for us.
Yeah.
What did the
Whatever
warden
happened to that
do? Because I can't imagine the warden, especially if he had algebra with Dima, I can't imagine that he saw Dima in this
and was okay with
shit.
This. Like, clearly he's going to have an issue with this, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because this is a demigod going out of control, which is... this is a demigod going out of control, which is exactly what his organization's trying to stop. Yeah. So he should theoretically try to stop the Dean. So maybe we can use the line to our advantage and get them to help us take the Dean down.
Yeah.
Or the Dean, being the demigod of balance, uses his ability to mask whatever his intentions are to say that, whatever, you know, him coming after us and doing all of this is to balance out all the power. And maybe the line might buy that.
I mean, I could tell the line that I broke his Seeker Stone. Surely they might know about that.
Yeah.
then I'll get in trouble. But hey, we'll deal with that.
We'll deal with it all later.
Yeah. We are in no short stick of trouble right now. Oh, Lord. Well, I guess the path right now in front of us is, do we...
How is ours working without, like, a person being killed in the bottom? Like, it's just water, right?
Yours has, from what you were under, from what you've
that
been
one
told.
Different, though?
Yeah, there's a, well, it was larger. Mm-hmm. But what you have is a barrel that is made out of iron wood and bound with iron, and there's lots of ruins, so the barrel is obviously magical in itself. There's a bar of heat metal, which is a very relatively simple magical item, and then there's a decanter of endless water, and it just creates unlimited steam without having to carry all the weight of the water to make the steam. That's why this works.
And why we don't need any fuel to keep it going.
Correct.
So do you think that they are torturing him, basically, to save on weight so they can put more people in there? Or just to torture him?
No, it's going to be bigger and faster. They're going to come for us.
They think we're going north, though.
They're seekers. We have no way to cloak ourselves.
I want to bust this shit right now. I want to bust the shit right now, gang.
God's trying to tempt us. God's trying to tempt us to go see it.
I know, and it's working. I really,
how about we go south?
I want to turn this airship. I want to crash it into that hangar. And listen, I got slow fall. I'm good.
Look, I'm all for that too, but I think at this point we need to look at the much bigger picture. And the bigger picture isn't the dean coming after us. It's the world's going to end in 5 years.
But how do we know that the compass is taking us to the more important thing than this temple?
But we have
to
trust Caitlin, right?
Because God came and gave
we
it
have
to you.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, the dean's going to be there. It's been 8 hours and he's doing this shit. He's going to be there. So I say we go find the compass and then see what's there. Maybe it could be something that could help us defeat the dean. And then we'll go back, maybe. Mm-hmm. And we could go find the Forgotten, and we could build this army, and we could take them out.
Just so I'm clear, where exactly does the... Because you were all in the cockpit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Where exactly does this compass take you, and where had you gotten this compass from?
The compass points south, like every other compass, because, you know, how needles are long, and they point both north and south. This one just points south.
Okay.
Wait, hold on. Is it pointing south right now, or is it kind of pointing like southeast?
Southeasty, yeah.
Okay, so scratch that. This compass is pointing towards something very plot heavy.
Something very integral to the plot. Aram shakes his head. And
that's all I can tell you, Malvorn.
You have a compass that points to the south.
You don't kind of.
And how did you get it?
I woke up with it on
Malvorn, it was
Mateus.
A gift from the gods.
You woke up from it because it was a gift from the gods.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. And we're going to simply follow that to the south.
Hey, my dude, guess what? 2 hours ago, I said if you don't want to come, you can leave.
It's fine. I'm here. Just want to understand the plan.
Yeah. Okay. So we're following the plot compass, and it appeared on my titties from the gods. And that's just what we're
I
doing.
I wish you had two so that you could cover it like Ariel style.
Yeah, like a little
Barb as Ariel.
Malvorn, did you have a better idea?
I know people are.
The only ideas I have right now is that we are stronger together, and some of us appear to be in trouble, but we can return. Yep. Whatever you believe is safest. We have responsibilities now.
I'll be back, you guys. I'm gonna go talk with Cree and Zali. I think we need to ramp up our
defenses
here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, full speed ahead to southeast.
All right. And so you're heading downstairs. Well, are you gonna go talk to Cree first?
Yeah, I want to get Cree and Zali.
All right. So you're heading. I think they're in the same room, right? Weren't they in the same room?
Oh, I can look at my notes.
Really? You honestly have these notes?
Yeah,
you know which ones are in the same room?
I wrote down who. What the
you
sleeping arrangement
are
was.
A treasure. I just want to point that out.
We have to know where everyone's sleeping.
No, I mean, of course.
we must.
Otherwise, hijinks will ensue.
Aram.
Yeah.
Never mind. You go first.
Okay. No, Zali is sharing a room with Ballora, and Kree is sharing a room with Slugs.
Ballora.
Oh, okay. So perfect.
Ages.
Yeah. All right. So
these are the rooms. Yeah. Room one's Wendell Astrid, Malvorn Varrock.
Anyone
Slugs,
need a potion? Does any no?
She's so sweet. Also, I loved on Twitter you pulling out these random hobbies. You're like Tula paints watercolor. I'm like, what did that happen in the plot?
Tula paints photorealistic.
Oh, photorealistic.
Paint,
landscapes.
Portraits. Portraits, yeah.
Fascinating. What's going on?
Yeah, so there's two separate rooms, but I'm sure he could be like, hey, you two, meet me in the captain's quarters.
Like, it's daytime and like flying. Probably not sleeping.
I want to go after Theodore.
Okay, so you're actually...
Get him.
Okay.
Get him. Get
come
him,
here.
Janice.
Come here. Get back over
here.
So you guys are heading towards Kreese?
Theodore.
Oh, yeah.
I want to ask you something.
Of course.
Something that came up earlier.
Hallway scene!
Hallway scene!
Take a shot, audience!
Did I just trigger a hallway scene?
Yes, you did.
We need like a bunch of sound effects to go off for the hallway.
Always see music plays. Dun, 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 dun. This is Pokemon battle music.
Sorry, it was something that you said earlier. That's mine. Don't drink that.
Sorry.
Don't be drinking my glass.
Thank you.
Wait, what is yours, Janice?
It's not even Dunkin' Donuts coffee, just salt water, and you're like,
it's nothing like what I was going for whatsoever.
I have a Dr. Pepper, too.
Oh, hey, a liquid.
Oh, God.
You said earlier that you asked me if I would have done that thing that I did to Vrock to any of you. Do you guys not trust me?
Hey, Mackenzie, do you want to go to the other room?
Yeah, fuck, oh fuck. Have fun, Joey, have fun.
Valid question, though. Is the AC
as high as it can go?
Okay. I mean, we have to trust you.
I just want to make sure that you know, and I'll tell Astrid and Barb as well that I don't think I would ever, I wouldn't do that without asking for your permission first, or at least telling you that it was going to happen, I suppose. I know I don't really talk much about myself here. I've been a little bit guarded. So, yeah, that comment just threw me off. I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I get it. It just, I didn't realize that you could do something to that extent, and with everything going on, and with, we really don't know who to trust. But I know that we can, and I do trust you. You grabbed a secret from all of us without... Well, you didn't have to ask us, but you did. And you covered for it. You didn't tell anybody, and as far as I know, you haven't told anyone. So it's a non-issue.
Yeah, that... You know, I'm sure you're experiencing this too. I have all sorts of powers and abilities now that are just manifesting itself, and to be honest, I sometimes hear things from all of you.
That must be really hard.
I mean, that's who I am, I guess, right? But it's a little odd. It's not what I'm used to. But you know, growing up, I think, I guess it's always been there. I've always kind of heard a voice in my head. I turn and look at a mirror. Just very subtly.
Is she there when he looks into the mirror?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So she is, so even though she's inside of you, she's still in the mirror?
Mm-hmm. No.
Little wave.
Anyway, thank you for reassuring me. I just wanted to make sure that was... Just wanted to let you know that I would never do that.
Desdemona, like, kind of puts her arms out and now is wearing Astrid's clothes, and her hair is up like Astrid. And she's
Astrid
like,
doesn't wear her hair.
My hair
like,
is down.
Astrid doesn't wear her hair up.
Her hair is up. And she kind of.
She wants to look like the unofficial art.
Like this, darling.
And she dances around with her little hands, and she has like two tiny little swords that appear in her arms, and she does this.
I just
this.
Like put my hand in the mirror.
And then she kind of looks around the hand, looks around the, and she pulls up like a little wolf's pelt around her.
What is she doing?
Poses with it.
So you probably Six see me kind down. Of like acting a little strange, yeah. like looking at the mirror. Like,
do you hear things from non people, like from non living things? Can you?
Oh, like no. That I think they have to have a mind. So sometimes I find it weird looking in mirrors. I know how odd that might sound, but
she comes back and she's got like a big old diamond headpiece thing that where her face kind of sticks out, and she's got a sword and
a
shield.
Costume trunk. Desdemona's costume trunk.
Anyway, go do what you were going to do. Okay. Thank you for talking to me and hearing me out.
And I mean, if you ever feel like there's trust issues, I appreciate you saying something like that. A lot of people wouldn't even try to do that. So
yeah, that I mean, the way I was raised and where my line of work and being here, this is all just kind of very natural for me to keep inward.
What did you do for work?
I was a
And you're from Ani, right?
I'm from Ani, yeah.
He's 14.
I entertained.
Tell me about your pension, the 14-year-old says.
Do you have a 401k? Says the 14-year-old.
I know a really great accountant up in Rizon, but they're really good.
Well, you were a soldier, and you were kind of raised in that environment, so I think I grew up in something very similar. I was raised to be a courtier, to kind of entertain certain people of interest.
That's interesting. I don't think Theodore has any idea what a courtier is.
No.
At all.
As far as you're concerned, it's like a really fancy bellhop.
I think Theodore thought he said courier.
Right.
That's what I was. And,
yeah.
Like Barb.
Barb was, right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, like a lot of the things that I do, like the way I play my instrument, I dance. Those are things that they taught me at my school. So
that's amazing. You're really good at the
the lyre,
yeah, that thing.
Thank you. I practice a lot.
It's beautiful, and it shows.
Thanks. So anyway, I look over at the mirror. You can continue on. Sorry, I didn't mean to stop you in the middle of where you were going.
No, it's okay. Let me know if you need anything. I'm going to try to get some weapons on here.
Okay. As Theodore leaves, I turn and look at the mirror.
And she's now Medina, and it's just like...
Oh, what the fuck?
Not hard?
All the way up to the neck and like, you know...
She's not covered in bones?
Really, why don't she got no bone costume?
That's what she picked.
Fuck off. Not good enough for your fanfic.
Daz, you need to behave yourself.
Oh, but I'm so bored. I am behaving myself. Why don't we go start a little trouble? Why don't you let me out?
I was going to ask you about that.
Yeah.
So what happens? You just borrow my body for a little bit?
Oh, it was so wonderful. I felt so alive, so touched into you, so connected.
I mean, I do feel bad. You're always kind of just stuck there.
It's so boring here. And the smell of blood. Oh. It was amazing.
That's...
What if we just...
A little odd.
What if Meanwhile, Varag goes, who are you talking to? I've been standing here the whole time. And Slugs goes, yeah, I've also been standing here the whole time.
I actually practice talking into a mirror about an hour a day. It makes me feel better about myself.
The two characters are always floating in the back of every scene.
What if we
That same with Theodore was really good.
What if we fly above the temple and then flip on Janice and drop him like a grenade into the arena?
I do forget we have this new Hulk Janice.
Yeah.
All right.
Are you saying you... Like, do you want to try it out? I'm not sure when to do it. It feels odd.
Anytime you want. Anytime.
Do I get control? Do I get to have a little bit of... Do I get to say when you get to leave? It seems...
You know, I can't lie to you, sweetie. Nose across the board.
We have to set down some ground rules.
Okay. You think about them, and I'll be right here. And she, poof. And like, she makes a little poof, but you can clearly see her just like going down, like just kneeling down where she's out of the side of the mirror.
Like when someone does that, I'm going down the stairs. Like,
totally.
Exactly. 100%.
I still see you, Desdemona.
And she peeks back up, and I can see you, and you better watch out. And as soon as she says that, there's an explosion.
The whole ship rushes
to the left. Like, you all feel it lurch all the way to the left.
Did Teodoro at least get to go say, hey, guys, can we put some weapons on the ship?
Then swing back, and the whole ship stutters and begins to shake.
Do you want us to do that at the table?
Okay.
Yeah, go. Ready? Ready? Left.
3, 2, 1.
Then back to the right. Well done.
What happened?
That was like Ballora.
What happened?
You will hear the propeller spinning down and a very excitable, what the hell is his name? Malvorn.
There's so many.
Yeah, sorry. A very excitable Malvorn from the cockpit.
Excitable, like in a good way?
No. As in, I have no power. Well, I have no power.
Theoretically, I would have been there.
Yes,
right?
Fair enough.
Because I'm really only they left.
Perfect.
So would me and Barb still be in the cockpit or
Perfect.
Near it? I don't know.
So, yeah.
What's wrong, Malcolm? What's
so
wrong?
So, from what you guys saw, then okay. What is his name? Ren. Ren got up and he was like going to go, you know, to pee basically. And he got up for a
fantasy piss
for a moment. Well, you got to go somewhere. You got to pee, you know.
We can cast fireball. You still got
to
pee.
Yeah, you still have to pee. So he gets up, and a few moments later, there's this explosion. It rocks you all to the side. The canopy swings back. The whole ship seems to shudder. The propellers are shutting down. And Malvorn is like trying to turn this wheel, but is losing all control. And there's like some dials and whatever else, and he's looking at it for a moment, and he's looking at his scribe pad. He doesn't understand what's happening, and then he realizes what's happening. It's that Theo have lost pressure. All the steam pressure is plummeting, so he's losing control and losing altitude.
I grab the shell from your hands. I slam it in.
Yeah.
Okay. You slam the shell. And
right. It gave it power. Right.
Yeah. It. Well, it gave it direction. And
I thought you said it got more powerful when the...
It's kind of lit up, but it didn't really give it more power.
Oh, I thought you said there was more steam and stuff coming from it.
It created more steam because it was going faster.
Okay.
Yeah.
Never mind.
So,
that didn't work, probably.
Yeah, you turn a little bit, but otherwise than that, it's still losing altitude.
That didn't work at all. I thought I missaw it earlier.
Malvorn, then we need more pressure?
Can I go downstairs and see what the fuck's up in the engine room?
Someone's going to have to as he's trying to pull.
I'll run. Oh, I'm quick. Yeah. We're both quick.
I'll run.
Hail the engine room.
Scotty, what's going on down there? So,
you guys run downstairs, and out of the right side of this barrel is just a gout of steam that is pouring out, filling the whole room.
There's no one in this fucking cast of demigods.
So I'll cover my mouth, I guess, a bit. I'll pull like my shirt up a bit to cover my mouth from the steam. And
no.
Who? What are the powers on this ship? Who can...
Ballora, pour a potion in
here. I mean,
here.
Yeah, is there a potion of mending? Ballora, what you got?
Wait.
No, but
actually...
Yes?
Yes, hang on. And
what?
She goes
the
running
fuck?
Back to her room.
Because I'm trying to think, I'm like, I don't know of anybody else that could...
Green, she can make metal things, he can heat them up.
But she has to
use them.
She has to
literally
focus.
Weld it.
Yeah, you're with them, so I guess you could...
I'm assuming...
You walk in the room, you're like, hey, can I talk to you?
So, Ballora comes, you know, running back a few minutes later, and she's got several bottles with her, and she's like, can you stop the steam?
Can I?
Yes.
Stop this? I don't know.
Okay, Ren has now run downstairs, and he's like, yes, you can, but we'll lose... We'll fall even faster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What the hell happened? Did we like blow a casket or what?
I think so.
Malvern's yelling, we can't turn and we're going over the valley.
Oh shit.
Well,
I thought we were over the ocean. When did we get to the valley?
You had just turned back over. Because
Aram, cut to
I'm
Aram.
No magic user.
Aram on our last break. I'm glad you guys have a ship. You can get wherever you need to go. I mean, it immediately breaks the ship.
Well, Ballora said she had something, right?
Yeah.
But she has to get rid of the steam. I trust you. Give her the steam and let Ballora do whatever she wants to do.
All right. And he barks out a command word, and the water starts, stops pouring out.
And I yell at everybody, and I say, I yell to the gentleman, I'm like, brace for impact, possibly! Just to radiate through the ship.
Wait, well, brace for what?
Impact, I don't know.
Brace.
Oh, no. Brace for impact, everyone. Brace for impact.
Yeah.
Tell us about trying to the hug as many Wendell, people against
not,
the wall.
But what about water stuff?
Varrock.
And Varrock.
I don't know.
Waterfalls.
We need to get anybody else down here.
Anybody except us.
Yeah.
Constellations and bones are not the problem.
Varrock, get down there.
All right. Varrock is like, right? Like,
come on.
What can I do? I don't.
Can you make a waterfall?
Can I?
Because if Dimran can seal this, then he can create more water and we can build up the pressure again.
Ballora.
Ballora. Did I say Dimran?
Yeah.
I mean, Dimran would have been fucking
Dimran
amazing.
Been touch yeah, done.
Dimran would have been the best person for this
100,
damn job.
100%.
Yeah.
And he's, I think so. Okay.
So if the steam is gone, what can Ballora do?
Ballora, can you move fast? She's like, yeah, I think so. Okay.
You got it, buddy. You got
go.
It.
Go! And he just throws both hands over it and grabs it and starts pulling the wood together. You can see the steam ripping through the sides of his fingers and his hands.
Are you okay?
And he's like his teeth are gritting and he's sweating balls, but he's able to close the gap.
Sorry, nothing pulled me out more.
Sorry. I know, sweating balls is not a very, 13th century term, is it?
Is he getting injured?
Yes, he's definitely being injured. Ballora... Natural 20.
Yes, I saw that.
All right.
Go, girl, go, go,
so
go.
Ballora's like, pop, pop, pop. She got three bottles. She's running lines of liquid.
She's like
on
a bartender. On
the, yeah, exactly. Mixed drinks, shaking it up, pouring it back down.
And do you want that on ice? Or
you see it start to re-knit. The wood began to re-knit. And as he's closing it together and helping pull it shut, Varrock is able to let go. And you see the last threads of the wood reconnect, and as soon as it's done, she turns like, it's done, and Ren is like, okay, and shouts out the command word again. Water starts flowing, steam starts generating, and you can hear Malvorn yelling.
Bad.
Is it ever good with them?
Are we pulling up?
Someone go check on it.
You're starting to now pull up.
Varrock's hands look like?
Varrock's hands are like red. And, blistered.
Pull out one of my healing potions and pour them on his hands?
Totally.
I don't know. I want to help him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to help heal him. Thank you for doing that. Thank you.
Thank you for healing my hands.
Thank you for doing that. You didn't have to, and that was... You hurt yourself. Thank
you.
Well,
I'm on this ship. I did kind of have to.
Well, thank you. Anyway.
Okay, I'm running to Malvorn. Come on.
Yeah. All
right. I want to make sure our people are taken care of.
No, totally. So you run up. You're like, you like push past a Kree and you push past a couple of the others around the hallway. What's going on?
If I see any magic users, I'm saying magic users to the hall now. Make sure that Varrock is okay.
Oh, okay. And Kree goes taking off, half flying. And you get to the cockpit, and Malvorn is, pulling on the thing and also trying to get the little shell off because he has no control over the ship.
Okay, I'm going to try to take the shell off again.
All right, roll strike.
God damn it.
Well, we're past the temple now, right? Don't we want the shell to lead us?
I mean, yeah. How much of a course correction is it really
so
doing?
You went out and you've dove into the valley. You want to make sure you can climb out of it. I mean, assumedly the autopilot would climb out of it, but Malvorn would like control.
Well, he always wants control.
Yeah.
As long as the autopilot isn't going to crash us, we should keep it.
But does the autopilot have a sensor to know that there's a
Tesla?
I'll try it anyway. I'm not. Yeah, I'm not.
Take it out.
Yeah. That's a strength check.
Yeah.
Just flat strength.
Yeah.
22.
All right. And you know about the weakness of the lid now, so you're able to pry it carefully off.
Also, I don't need any strength bonuses.
Right, exactly, because you're amazing. And the ship is back in Malvorn's control. He's still pulling back hard. Ren shows up a moment later, also grabs a stick, and is pulling back hard.
Grab a stick, Ren.
Already done. And the ship pulls out of the valley and begins to level off again.
Fuck. Does anyone know what caused
that? What happened?
Yeah, what happened?
Can I go down and help investigate at
this
point?
Yeah,
I assume, like, if depending on how quickly Rock can heal, probably me, Kree, and Rock are down there.
Yeah.
I'm still trying to help his
hands. Kree's down there, like, you know, I was told to bring magic. What can I do?
I don't know. Do you feel okay, Rock? Do you need healing other than...
No, this is much better. Okay. I am fine. Thank you.
Yeah. So it's me, Rock, and Kree. What a crew. I'm the one both of you don't have interest in.
Really?
The one of all of us.
Right, yeah.
Wow. Do you, I don't know if you know about ships, do you know what would have caused that?
And?
I want to look around, see if maybe there was, if something maybe came in, like, did the this sounds weird, was the wound, was it like entry or was out, like did it look like something came out of it or into it?
So you start to check the hole as Theodore walks downstairs. Roll me an investigation.
I'm so anxious.
Mm-mm. Okay.
Investigation?
Yeah.
That's a 14.
Okay. So you're kind of running your fingers along the wall and you don't find any holes or injuries or place where something would have entered the ship. You don't seem to find anything.
On, like, the barrel thing. I mean, it's sealed now.
Right.
Yeah, so I can't really tell if anything, like, came out of it. Or
it's difficult for you. You don't really see anything.
Right.
Theodore.
Can I just kind of come... Like, well, running down, I guess. It's pretty important to be there. I want to...
Little legs.
little legs. Pull off one of my pouches and just, like, pull open... like, pull off the string of it and then... flip out my tinkers and smithing toolkits.
Fair enough.
And I want to go look and see what the heck just happened. If there's anything that's been tampered with, if there's anything that was a weakness point.
I would like you to roll investigation with advantage, right, since you're using that kit.
It's not great.
Theodore CSI.
Okay. 20.
Okay. The following things you know.
I'm like, And Theodore comes in and goes like, bitch, it's over there.
So you were able to see this one part too. You both were, you know, saw that a separation had formed between two of the barrels of slats so that they were separated. And that's how the steam was prying out. And that's what you were able to see as well. You see on the where the two slats have been healed that there are tool markings on the boards that indicate they were pried apart, likely with a crowbar or something similar. But the last thing you see...
A foot.
Just Ren said he was in the bathroom.
You take your nail, and you run your nail just on the edge of the board and pull it back, and there's a silvery dust underneath your nail.
Silvery dust.
Any divine... energy from the goggles?
I mean, it's on your finger, so
did you like it, really?
I mean, it's glowing really brightly, but you couldn't tell the difference between your own divine energy.
Oh, well, yeah. Shit. Yeah,
yeah. And looking at it on the barrel, you're not really seeing anything beyond the fact that there's a very slight glow from any magical item. Mm-hmm. Obviously, divinity is much brighter, but magic has a little bit of a glow, and the whole barrel is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Somebody tampered with this.
Who would have been down here?
I mean, any of us. We don't know where everybody is at every second of the day.
Well, we know I was with Bob by the cockpit, and Malvorn was there, so we know where he was. You and Janice were in a hallway talking, right? I saw you two go in the same direction, I assume.
Yeah,
we're having a hallway scene, I assume.
Yeah, that's what happens.
I mean, Ren went to the bathroom.
But we don't know where anybody else has been either.
Yeah, I know, but those are the people I can account for was the people in the cockpit. Ren left. I know where Bob and I and Malvon were. I know where you two were. Unless...
If we think it's one of us, I think we're going to need Janice for this.
Yeah.
Get everybody together.
We're going to do some investigation.
I mean, let Janice...
How much of a mystery is this really?
I mean, well, if theoretically, if we bring
we
it, if we if we bring it,
it's not Ren.
If we,
Theodore will not believe that it's Ren. Just,
I think that's the seed. I think that's the seed that is trying to be planted. I mean, theoretically, Janus can sense a secret, right? So if we bring it up to the group, maybe he can get a little ping on somebody.
He smells it.
What if we...
Like a boar looking for truffles.
So Rock and Kree are both here. Rock, Kree, where were you two just now when this ship started going down?
Oh, I was...
Kree was with me.
I was with...
Did Teo end up actually making it to Kree and Zali?
No.
No.
Not quite there. Just almost there. And
my life. And short legs. Yeah. You never get there.
And Vrock was alone. I was completely alone.
Where were you?
I was alone in my room.
Okay.
Thinking
about Teodor.
No.
Looking at my drawings of Teodor. Kree, where were you?
I was in my room.
Everyone just in the bedrooms. 11 a.m.
Can we get our demigod of secrets and wrap this scene up?
What else do you want us to do? There's nowhere else to go. The only main area is in the back.
I know. Let's go. Let's go have a party.
Come with us, okay?
Okay. It walks out with you.
Yeah. Janus.
Yeah, I'm probably in the cockpit, right?
Yes.
I probably went back.
Yeah.
Right. Janus, we're going to need you to work your magic.
Did we find out what happened?
Somebody tampered with this. Somebody tried to take it down. There was a silver residue, and I'm like, hold on.
Does that look familiar?
Oh, that's odd.
To who?
This, just to me. Have I seen someone with, like, silvery shit?
Roll intelligence.
I don't know.
Who the fuck? I turn around. I'm looking at all these little
14.
14. Yeah, it feels familiar,
I'm
but
like,
you're...
Fuck.
Yeah.
I don't know where it's at the tip of my tongue.
Yep.
Is there magical properties to it? Can I see if there's anything of... So what? Arcana?
Roll Arcana.
Where is Marlon right now?
Ren is helping drive.
How come you won't play this game with me?
Because I'm legitimately confused and trying to figure out who you're talking about.
Joey just blew my fucking mind. He called it.
Eighteen.
Okay, so 18. You grab this silvery powder and you kind of rub it in between your fingers, and there's just you'll kind of like fuse it with a little bit of your own energy, right? And there is transmutation magic.
I know. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're figuring
it
out. Hey.
We got it.
A rum?
Yes.
Nope, don't. Do it in character.
I know.
What's going on, Janus?
Can I pull out my necklace?
Can we all look at each other at the same time and say the name?
Do you remember my necklace?
I do.
Can
remember
I pull
necklace.
It out? Does it match?
Okay, so you kind of put it right up next to it.
I pull my necklace out and I put it by the fingers.
There's transmutation magic on this. Someone who can create something.
Yep.
Oh, who's...
It
who
matches
the fuck can do that?
Perfectly.
And everyone in the Discord wants me to date her, and she just blew our ship up.
Where is she now?
Zoli! Baby, you want to talk?
All right.
I yell.
There's no answer, but there is a loud klaxon and the sound of gears, and you all can hear the back ramp lowering.
I'm double dashing.
I could do.
I was my feet double dash is what
I can do. Right, you too.
I have 90 feet.
Not double dash. I have 45.
It's not that big of a ship. You're all there. So
you
will
35
as a base wealth, and then I might have the mobile feet that gives me 10 more feet.
So you will burst into the back. Ballora is standing there with her hands kind of like up. Trembling.
Ballora, what's wrong?
And as you look past her, you can see the ramp lowering, Zali there with a sword out to Wendell's throat.
Oh. I'm gonna break this fucking microphone! Okay, I need to breathe.
Zali, what are you doing?
You're not Zali, are you?
Oh, I am. I always have been. And none of what you're doing is going to stop anything. Everything will die. Everything will be destroyed. And you can't stop it.
Zali.
You can't stop it.
Zali,
and
look
she's
at me.
Backing up, and like Wendell's feet are dragging just a little bit, and
Zali.
She's got him tight, and that blade is tight on his
Zali,
throat.
Zali, darling, and I touch my necklace. I'm like, this isn't who you are.
Right next to you is Luna.
Yeah.
Her head's down. She's not going anywhere further than you. She's right by your side, but you can feel the coiled up, you know, tension that is within her right now.
Yeah, no. I put my hand on my necklace and I say, Zali, this is not who you are. Remember who you are, Zali.
You've never known me. And the arm starts to go tight. I need initiative.
Fuck me. Fuck me and a stick. Fuck, dude. Oh, wait. I have an advantage on initiative. Wait.
There you go.
I still rolled shitty.
Oh, no. It's only because you're upset.
So, what names am I writing down here?
You are writing down... you're going to write down... Well, I'm not going to put Wendell in it yet, because Wendell's just basically...
Where are the otters? What are they doing?
Oh, that's a good... Yeah, he doesn't have the bags on him.
Fucking why?
Because he put them down. Because they're heavy.
And the ship just kind of like... Sure.
If we can break her concentration, maybe she'll lose that weapon.
Oh, yeah.
Thing. I mean, I think the most important thing is to take her out before she can fuck with Wendell.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I've got shield, so I can at least send it up so she doesn't slit his throat.
So I got Zali in this. Who else I got in this?
Sorry. Well, right now, Zali and just you guys.
Okay.
Others may join in quickly. I'm just going to pull up Zali. I've only got like 15,000 characters in D&D Beyond now. Archon this. Hi, Zali. Oh, I haven't picked the character with the bisexual haircut.
What?
You know, shaved. Yeah.
Everyone wanted me to date her in Discord, and now she's trying to kill my boy.
Yeah. Or at the very least, threatening. What did Wendell do to anyone?
Knife? Nothing. He did nothing wrong.
Nothing at all.
That's why I love him.
Yep. When I was trying to determine who she was going to take hostage, it was
always Wendell. You act like it was either going to be him or Varrock, and she can't
Varrock
physically
would be
hold
dumb.
Varrock.
Yeah, that'd be stupid.
She couldn't physically hold Varrock. I doubt
that was a bad hostage. No, it was going to be him or Ballora, or possibly Ren. Those were kind of the options.
can I have?
Oh, right.
30 to 25.
Jeez.
Oh,
30
did
to
you
25?
Get...
Oh, that's strange. Yeah, that's gonna be a 27 for Barb.
Oh. Since we're using the stack, should we start at the bottom?
No, I know. I have it.
Oh, okay.
I got it.
Nice.
That's why I was confused why you put me last in that one picture, because Barb will never go last in any initiative.
27.
That's true. I apologize.
Did you roll in that 20?
No, just an 18. I got a plus 9.
Wow. Why are you plus 9?
I got the alert.
Wow.
Can't be surprised. I see it all coming. The world's all fucked.
You didn't see this coming?
The world's fucked. A fuck thing happened. I'm like, okay, let's do this.
Right.
25 to 20. 20 to 15.
Oh, God.
Fucking.
20 to 15. 15 to 10.
12.
14.
13. I just beat this bitch. I just wanted a normal girlfriend.
9.
Those legs.
Those damn
legs. Wendell's not in this?
Wendell is not yet.
I doubt he can act.
He's like being grappled.
Wendell's kind of terrified.
He's probably fucking terrified. Look at that tower.
Nice. Where did you get that from?
Well, that was on Etsy, actually.
From who?
I cannot remember right now. I'm sorry. I feel bad.
We've got to plug. No, is it? I don't want to plug the wrong person. But
I feel bad. I even like.
Maybe we can add it in post, right?
Oh, yeah.
We can
totally.
Be like, this tower is by. And then
by the way,
put
this tower
you can
is
put
by.
A little text box of who did the tower. We should plug them so that they know we're using their
there
shit.
There you go. Did you ever do air traffic control?
No, I did not, sadly. Really? I wanted to, though.
Yeah,
and then, for podcast listeners, go to our Twitter. Maybe we'll post about it. Yeah. I don't know. You can post about who did the tower.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, podcast listeners aren't going to get your Vanna Whiting.
That's true, they're not. Yeah.
So I was like, we got to give something.
Yeah.
Well,
this just encourages the podcast listeners to watch us.
Wednesdays on twitch.tv/Godswall.
Or on YouTube at youtube.com/Godswall.
not the name of our show, but please go to it.
No, I just want, had to unify everything. I can't do two YouTube channels, and I can't do two Twitch channels.
No, I know. I was giving you crap.
Your communications wizard says don't separate your YouTube channels.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
Don't do that.
We're not cool enough.
Mm-mm, not yet. Soon, though.
All right, we doing this?
Yeah.
Barbarooney. What you gonna do?
Make it count, Bar. No pressure.
If, I mean, this is kind of like a weird thing, like, I guess, like, mechanics-wise, I don't know if she's holding an action technically or not, you know?
Right.
Because, like...
Well, no, you're seeing her arm. Yeah, she's definitely going to slash his throat on her turn. That's what you see her start to do. So you got two options. You could... Well...
Don't tell me how many options.
Three options. And you tell me if you got more.
You have no idea how many options I have.
These are three options that you could do, and then there's possibly more.
Gotcha.
You could attack her straight out.
Yeah.
You could, and hopefully, like, make her engage with you. You could do a attack just on her arm, right? You know, trying to knock the blade away or stop the blade, and that would you would roll at disadvantage because you're focusing on one target. Three, you could try to grapple her.
Yeah. Yeah.
Four, you could serenade her. Five, you could paint her a picture.
A photo, what is it? Photorealistic portrait. Like Tula would.
If you'd let Tula get back on the ship.
Wait, what was that
thing that hit the ship?
What was that thing that hit the ship?
Who knows?
It was Tula's dead body, then it fell to the floor and no one cares.
Do you think it's something that like fucked up Zali?
Zali, probably. Oh, maybe.
It might have been something that, because this is not her. This has not been her personality. But also, her personality's changed every time we've spoken to her, so maybe this was...
It was the fifth one buried deep beneath.
Oh no.
So here's what I'm gonna do. Within a second, you see Barb's arms double in length.
Nice.
As they kind of throw them out.
they just double in
they
length.
They just double in length through, like, this weird, like, sectioned, like, bone chain new arm. And they pull one back and kind of, like, bundle up this potential energy and just rocket it across trying to... it's called Gum Gum Bone.
Yeah.
It's my fourth level ability that I created. It is a 30-foot punch.
It's the most horrific mix between, like, Luffy and Inspector Gadget. Yeah.
It's awesome.
Okay. Yeah. I would like you to roll to hit.
Yeah.
And what are you aiming for?
Her fucking face.
Okay, fair enough.
Check it, check it. Thirteen.
That is not going to hit. So you swing, this big old arm comes out, but Zali's quick, and Zali just kind of flicks her head to the side and just punch, like, in between Zali and Wendell.
Then how far away are they from me?
They are 20 feet away.
Oh, sweet. Then I will run up and... I mean, deflurry of bones.
You know what? So you've done this, like, you know, go-go arm or whatever you whatever you call it, right? So it's like all the way stretched out, and then you run and kind of like get back to your hand, right?
And then the other arm goes.
Exactly.
So that's two attacks. That is going to be a 20 and a 23.
Both hit. Tell me what happens.
I kill her.
She dies.
If this is my way, hey, if you just want to know what happens, then I kill her.
That was good. That's quick. A plus. Yeah, could yak for me.
That is 14 points of damage.
14 points of damage. Okay, so you crack her across the face, throw another fist into her gut.
Yeah.
Her arm is still moving.
It's still moving?
Yeah.
I mean, well,
she's tough.
Listen, I'm just doing some damage here.
Yeah, that's right. 13, you said?
Yep.
13. 14. Sorry, 14 points of damage.
That extra one really counts.
Yeah. Who's next?
It's right in front of you.
Right, I'm so dumb. That's why we got this. Janice, you're up. You are up next.
Zolly, you must be joking, right? This is all just a joke, right? And as I do that, I'm going to cast Tasha's Hideous Laughter.
Oh, excellent. Okay. That'll make her drop what she's carrying, right?
She's going to fall incapacitated if you don't...
Outstanding. Sorry,
make a saving throw.
Accidentally moved off it. And that's going to be a wisdom saving throw?
Wisdom, yeah.
All right. Plus one. 18.
God damn piss.
Yeah. So you see her like her teeth grit and her eyes go wild for a second. And she's like looking at you with hate, but she's still giggling because she's just on the edge of it. But
what is going on with her?
She even looks more crazy now.
So I knew a little bit about what was going on between Zolly and Astrid way back. And I just say, how dare you do this to Astrid? And I give Astrid bardic inspiration.
Hello.
Speaking of which,
yeah,
it is Astrid's turn.
Yeah, so I grab onto this necklace and I say, you should know better than to touch him of all people. And I snap off that necklace and toss it. And I look at her, and behind her, these sort of like, and I focus my energy, and these sort of like three like little specks of light appear behind her.
Okay.
And start to sort of flare and shake and flare and shake, and then all go shooting at her at the same time. And this isn't the best use of this spell, but I want to hit her as many times as I possibly can.
Okay, what are you
casting?
So
my reticulum ray.
Yeah.
And so theoretically I should use on multiple people, but I want to kick her asshole right now.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
So it's three separate attack rolls for these. Each ray, each star, if you will. That one's really cocked. They're all so shitty. Yeah. One's a 17.
Okay, that hits.
And then the other one's like a 12, and the other one's like a 10.
Okay, so at the last moment, she follows your eyesight, and she sees the energy balls gathering, and she starts to turn and duck. One strikes her in the shoulder, but she gets out of the way of the other two.
The one does 8 points of radiant damage, and as she's looking away, Luna runs up and jumps to grab to bite her shoulder that's holding the blade. Does that make sense?
Yes. So that's a targeted thing. So Luna will have to do it with disadvantage.
Okay.
Unless she gets pack tactics.
It depends on if Wendell's part of her pack. Yeah.
100%.
Okay,
this is
straight. I'm up there too.
You're there. Yeah. So her pack's there. So she. So while Zolly turns around, I like look at Luna. I'm like, this
already
is your moment,
going,
darling.
Yeah.
Like she knows. She knows what to do. That's a 14.
A 14 does not hit.
Yeah. I can't use my inspiration on it because it's mine, not Astrid's, right? Not Luna's, right?
No, you could absolutely use your inspiration.
Yeah, I would think it would be an extension.
Luna's
of you.
Part of you.
Yeah. So what is it? Is it D6?
Yes, totally.
So it's 14.
Come on.
Plus 5, so 19.
Yes, that hits.
Yay.
The wolf. So that's 8 points of damage. So she runs up and sinks her claws or her teeth into her shoulder that's holding the blade.
Bites the shoulder. She 19 versus. Yeah, she drops the blade. She definitely drops the blade. She cries out, drops the blade, and Luna kind of like bears down, forces her to let go of Wendell, and then chucks her to the side, and she kind of hits the deck and rolls to the edge of the ramp and puts her fingers into the edge of it. So she's like half on and half off the ramp as it's open.
How far away is Wendell?
Well, Wendell is now being... basically, as soon as Luna stopped biting, Luna then turned back around, used her body to press against Wendell and push Wendell back away from the open.
I haven't used my movement. For my movement, I'm going to run to him.
You're there.
And be with him and Luna.
Absolutely.
And just grab onto him and put him behind me.
Yeah, he's...
And stand between him and Zolly.
He's crying. He's just crying. He's had a bad day.
I'll squeeze his hand. I'll put him behind me and I'll hold his hand and squeeze it and just stare at Zolly.
He's trying to be tough. Like he's getting in battle mode because he's trying to be tough. And his hand is gripping yours and he's trembling and you see him angry and you see him sad and then you see fur and then...
What the fuck?
You see
his nose kind of, a flatten. And his eyes extend and shift, and he turns into this, half otter, half creature thing, and he kind of gets low.
Gosh.
His teeth are now sharp fangs, and he's just like hissing at Zali at the edge of the thing.
Darling. Oh, I'll give him a little scritch. Holy shit. Okay. All right. Well, we're really going to build a zoo, baby.